They're in there. They're just hiding. The mama's up in that tree. Anyway, so I'm out expecting the plants in the area, reinforcing some of the plantings that I've already done, reinforcing the cantaloupe and the squash and the zucchini. And I'm over here checking out this bed, and I came across a weed, and I wanted to go ahead and show it to you. I can identify the weed. We call it purple root around here in Idaho. If you can see that root, let's see if I can get it to focus. Anyway, we came across these egg clusters, and I'm not real sure what they are. It's not on a plant. Well, it's on a plant, but it's not on a plant I care about. Let me give you a little better look at what the plant looks like, a plant rather, looks like growing. I'm not real sure what that plant is, but it's been eaten, and on the back side, look at there, see? Looks like a potato beetle, doesn't it? Something that looks like it's not supposed to be there. So it's strange seeing a potato beetle so far away from the potatoes. That's around where we had the russets last year. This year, we're just growing reds. Growing a nice row of them, and they look pretty. And I'm looking around on them, and I don't see any disease or bugs or anything. They just look fantastic, even going up to a little seed head and flowering. So I'm not real sure what to think of that. He was on a purple root. That's what we call it here in Idaho. A little plant like this gets huge, big. You're best to pull it when it's this low. It's got a tap root that goes a mile deep, not literally, but you know what I'm saying. So what I have here is a worm bin that I started about a year ago, and it needs to be harvested and moved. Now we're going to put together this worm bin, and I'm going to give you the parts and pieces that I'm going to use for it. First, I got one of these air filters. These are the cut-to-fit air filters for heaters and other furnaces. Your 3/4-inch threaded tubing adapter, like for a water hose, get two of those. 2-inch PVC. 2-inch cap, 3/4-inch vinyl tubing, just a small section, a 2-inch coupling here, a 2-inch reducer to 3/4-inch threaded. Get a nice cheap roll of 36-inch wide fiberglass screen tarp clamps like these. Now to play it safe, I've got a 55-gallon drum that had food in it. Now you can see here there's a hole there already for the plug, and that actually fits the 2-inch pipe pretty close, pretty nice, because you're going to want a nice tight snug fit. However, do you see the distance here? It would have to fill up pretty much to this point laying on this side before you get any drainage out to your pipe, and you don't want this much liquid in there. So I'm going to make a hole right here, just on the bottom, where I'm going to call my bottom. And of course, this, like I said, this is going to be a imperfect measurement, but you can see here how the cap that we're using is almost the diameter of our 2-inch pipe. Take a good old-fashioned Sharpie marker. Now that's a rough draft, okay? Remember, you'll have to cut on the inside of that because the marking is on the outside of the fitting. Now, if you're lucky enough to have one of these that's big enough for this, then by all means, but I don't. And so I'm going to just use this one to get it started before I use my saw. Look at there, that went in like a charm. Nice and tight. I got a little bit of breakage here, but a little bit of caulk won't hurt. But we want to seal that up really nice. So now we're going to do the other side. Now go ahead and cut your bottom hole. There, that's a nice and snug fit. Now, as far as the opening is concerned, I noticed that this one did pretty well. It was easy to access. It was easy to put stuff in, and it looks like it's going to be pretty easy to harvest out. All you got to really do is gather up the worms on the top and then dump the rest out and then use it in your garden. So I think this, we're going to mimic this particular same system here and just use a large square opening and use this piece of screen to try to keep the bugs out. Regarding your black pipe, you've got two factors you need to consider here. Number one is the length of your barrel. You don't want it to be too long to stick out, and also the width of your filter. You want to make sure that you don't cut the holes past the width of the filter, or you may plug up your pipe, and I'm going to show you that real quick. As you see here, the length of the filter is about as tall as the barrel is, and so that's perfect. And so with your pipe, your black pipe, you want to cut holes in it to match the length of the filter, but no longer. Now, I've gotten to thinking that we don't need to drill holes all around this pipe. It doesn't have to go on the top or the sides. We just need a few large holes on the bottom of this pipe. And the reason for that is that's where the water is going to drain, or the liquid is going to drain, we want to get out. And so we probably will only poke holes in the bottom. Now, I like this idea because it gives a little side gap to it as it's pressed on the bottom of the tank and will allow the water to seep in, or the liquid to seep in, as the worms decompose all the food matter. And so I like this idea. This is good. Now what we're going to do is cut our hole in this. Okay, once you get it cleaned out the best you can, remember worms are going in here, it doesn't have to be perfect. We go ahead and make sure that we have a port coming out of one side a little bit longer than on the other side. The other side has a long tube coming out, and we're fixing to cut this off right here. Okay, the cut doesn't have to be surgical. We're just going to put a cap on it. Don't glue it. There's no need to glue it. There won't be any pressure in this particular pipe, so we're just going to go ahead and set it on there. That way, if we ever need to, if it ever gets plugged up and we need to run something through it to unplug it, that way we can just take the pieces off rather than having to cut them again. Now on the inside, we need to put our filter in. I'm going to show you what I'm going to do here. It's going to be kind of a just a wedge in place, if you know what I'm saying. I just triple fold the filter, and I'm just going to literally cram it in under this pipe. May not be a perfect system, but it's something I'm going to try, and hopefully it'll work well. So you see there, just triple fold that filter and place it under there, basically plug in the opening of those holes. So when the water comes through, or the liquid comes through, it'll drain filtered out through that particular, those holes, and then out to the port. And I'll show you the port I'm going to make right now. Okay, here's the exit right here. I'm going to set up my hardware. I'm not going to glue anything. I'm just going to go ahead and wedge it in there. Go ahead and set your couplink in. Stick on your reducer. And then put your tubing on the end. Now this part right here, this is your exit. This is where you'll drain from. I'm going to go ahead and just put a cap. Regular old-fashioned water hose cap. Just like that. Basically, when this fills full of that worm tea or black liquid, that's when you pull this off and drain it. Use it in your plants, use it for whatever you want to use it. I like to use the clear tubing because I can see the liquid will probably fill into here, and once it fills in, I'll know that it's ready to be drained. Now right now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and set this bin up with bedding. Now go down to your local newspaper, if you still have one, and see if you can find yourself an end roll. This is an end roll for newspaper. It doesn't have any ink on it. It's just good old-fashioned paper. Paper's made of cellulose, plants. The paper will mold up when it's wet. The worms eat the mold, and the mold continues to grow on the paper, and eventually the paper disappears altogether. It's bedding is what you want to use it. Run it through your shredder. Take your bedding and just fill it in here. just like that. Now you want to wet it down. You don't want to make it soggy. You want to wet it down to where it's, you squeeze it and then you don't get any water that comes out. This part takes a while. Now you see when you get it wet, it compacts pretty good. Not too much, but it packs down. You don't want to fill this thing all the way up with newspaper shreddings. You want to be able to put some food in it as well for your worms, some actual nutrition. So we're going to go ahead and clean out our old worm bin and get it ready for this worm bin. And we're going to do it kind of side by side. As we find worms, we're going to put them in here and we're going to kind of go that route. Now let me show you around my old worm bin. I put these grass clippings in a while back, but you can see, if I can get down into it, you can find some worms, and there's millions of them. This is what you're looking for. A nice, loose, coffee ground looking casting dirt, if you know what I'm saying. This is what you're looking for. But anyway, so I'm gonna take a lot of the castings out of here and a lot of the worms, and I'm gonna put them on in here and let them start doing their thing. Also, you wanna get yourself some sand. Go to the child sandbox and get you a little handful of sand and put it in there. Worms need sand for their crops, kind of like birds and doves and stuff. They like a little rocks in their crop in order to process food, and worms do the same thing. Let me show you what I do. A little handful of sand like that does perfect. And you get back, take the sand and just sprinkle it on top. They'll find it. Now the worms you want to use are called red wigglers. Now when I set up my worm bin, I set up in three different zones. Zone 1, zone 2, and zone 3. And the way I do this is I'll come in here and I'll lay some debris in here, some scraps from the kitchen here. A few days later, I'll have some for here, and a few days later, I'll have some from here. Now if I come back after that third dropping, and on the fourth dropping, I come to add more, and there's still stuff that's not been broke down, then I put that out in my regular compost. I don't add it to here. I don't want so much rotten food that they can't handle it. I want them to be. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna set up a screen system here like I had on the old one, and we'll get that set up so to keep the flies and the gnats and things like that out of it. What you wanna do is you wanna go ahead and punch in 5 holes into the top of this container. That way you can bolt a screen, a cover on it, so that the flies and the gnats and things like that won't be able to get into it as easily if you just had this great big open hole. And so I go ahead and punch in 5 holes, and I use plastic bolts. Plastic bolts won't rot, and let me show you how I'm doing it real quick. Now fold your screen over 3 or 4 times to reinforce it. Put in your 2 end bolts first, and then do your center, and then the other 2 as well. I do 5. Now cut your screen extra long, and I'm going to show you why. You're going to want to get a hold of some of these tarp clamps like these. So you take the clamps and you clamp them down after you roll up the screen 3 or 4 times and weigh it down with something. Now that we've got our worm bin set up, let's go ahead and feed them some goodies. Spread that around real good and cover it up.
If to Jesus you'll pray, and to Him you'll be true. Fall down on your knees and call out His name. You'll be free from your sin and be saved from the flame.
I made this.